Welcome back. In today's lecture, I am going to talk about input to state stability. Okay. So far what we have seen that I have some kind of nonlinear system that is represented by some kind of autonomous or non-autonomous equation like this. And we are assuming that these two models are valid in some particular region D, and that D is subset of Rn. And after that, we are also assuming that I have equilibrium point inside this region D. So origin is going to contain inside this region. And after that, we are seeing the stability about the equilibrium point. And why? Because we know that property of equilibrium point is like this. If you start from there, you are going to stay there. Okay. And due to that reason, we are now going to see the behavior that if my initial condition is not exactly at the equilibrium point, that is little bit away from the equilibrium point, then what is my behavior? And what we found that if I will not start at the equilibrium point, but in the neighborhood of the equilibrium point, and if I remains bounded, then we have defined stability. If I converge to the equilibrium point, we have defined the asymptotic stability. And if I have some kind of rate also, then we have defined the exponential stability. Okay. So these all stability concept is somehow in linear control theory, we are telling this as a internal stability. Okay. In nonlinear control theory, obviously, we are not telling this as a internal stability. We are telling this as a Lyapunov stability about the equilibrium point. Okay. In today's lecture, what we are going to see now that whenever I have system like this now, f, x, or u, so this is force system, or more general system you can consider, that suppose I have system like this, so non-autonomous force system I am telling, so I can able to analyze the stability again in the similar way about the equilibrium point by substituting or by designing control. Suppose if I define control like some function alpha, and that is function of tx, or I have second way that I will assume that control is just function of x. So in this way, I can design the control, and after that, I am going to keep that control here. Then it is possible to show that again, this system is transformed like this. And again, I can able to analyze the stability of closed loop system about the equilibrium point. Okay. So now, one more important question is that if we are able to analyze the stability about the equilibrium point, then what is need of the extra notion of stability? Okay. So what people are telling, even if closed loop system is stable, but always there exists some kind of unknown input. Okay. Because whatever control we are going to design, we are going to design it inside lab or some kind of sophisticated place, but always some kind of input is there. So even if this closed loop system is behave nicely, now we have to make sure that if some kind of external input is here, so with respect to that external input, either that is known or unknown, but remains bounded, then whatever our behavior, so I will not expect same kind of behavior, but at least I can tell that now if trajectory is going to converge to the equilibrium point, so that will not converge but remains in the vicinity of equilibrium point if I have certain disturbance or something like that. Okay. So now what we are going to do, we are going to see the response in terms of input and or output, and here output you can assume for time being as a all state variable. Okay. So I am telling that this system is behaving in such a way such that I have n number of sensor and I am able to look towards all state as a output. Okay. And due to that reason, I am not writing here input to output stability, I am writing input to state stability. Okay. So assumption is remains the same, all states are known to me. Okay. So now what we are going to see in today's lecture, that if closed loop system is stable, again in Lyapunov sense, and if this input, either known or unknown, if that is bounded, then output is bounded or not. So that kind of things I am going to explore in the today's lecture. Okay, so let us try to see here that again I have started with this system, and I have told you that this is nothing but non-autonomous force system. Okay, so non-autonomous, why? Because T is explicitly involved and Tx is involved, and obviously external quantity forcing function U, and due to that reason I have added one extra word, force. So non-linear force system. Again, for existence and uniqueness of solution, what I am assuming, now you can see that I have extra variable U, okay, so or extra argument U, okay, so I have to make sure that this function f is piecewise continuous in T but locally Lipschitz with respect to control as well as state. Okay, so extra assumption is now required in order to make sure that there exists a unique solution. Anyone has confusion on this? So at least using this kind of assumption, I can tell that there exists a local solution. I cannot give guarantee because globally I am not assuming. Okay, due to that reason, at least I can assume that I have local solution. Anyone has confusion on this, then please let me know. So now what I am going to do, I hope that you don't have confusion on the solution. Now what I am going to assume that UT is piecewise continuous, because you can see that control I can design, I have told you that is, I can design control that is non-linear function of X and T. Okay, so if T is also involved, means control is depending on time, then we are assuming that piecewise continuous control is okay for me. Why that is okay? Because we are assuming that in order to talk about the solution, I have assumption like that f is piecewise continuous in T. So due to that reason, piecewise input is allowed, and obviously I cannot expect that for unbounded output, whatever my closed loop system, if they have certain behavior, or without control, if some certain behavior, then same behavior will remain. And due to that reason, this assumption is reasonable. Because control or forcing function I am going to apply, and I cannot tell that whatever forcing function I am going to apply or design, so that is infinity. Most of time that is limited. Okay, and due to that reason, that assumption is also physically supported, you can tell that, or practically supported. Now what I am going to assume, that without control input U is zero, then this system, you can see that this system has equilibrium point, unique equilibrium point x equal to 0, and about that equilibrium point, that is globally uniformly asymptotically stable. Could you please tell me that why this word is required, uniformly idem? Could you please tell me why uniformly word is required here?
Sir, because the solution is defined in the space R.
So why not globally asymptotically stable? Why uniformly?
Sir, because it is not depending on the time T naught initially.
Yeah, actually this is non-autonomous system. Okay, and in non-autonomous system, now what we are expecting, that whatever solution, my solution, that is independent of the selection of initial time. Due to that reason, I have used this kind of word. Anyone has confusion? Okay, now what I am telling, and if suppose Iram, if I remove this time T, then what kind of assumption is required? What do you think? Iram?
Sir, yes, sir.
Then what do
you think? Which time, sir? Sorry.
If I remove this time here, or I will convert this autonomous system here, I have taken this system. Suppose if I will take this system, X and U. Okay. So here, yes, you can see that this is autonomous system. So what kind of I have to make sure that X and 0. So what kind of assumption for this system, for the stability, what kind of assumption one can expect for this system, autonomous system?
Sir, globally asymptotically.
Yeah, globally asymptotically stability is enough, because now actually time is not explicitly involved, and due to that reason, so just I am willing to make confirm that you are able to understand each and every word or not. Okay, now question is that what can we say the behavior of system one, I have this non-autonomous force system. Now, what I am telling that if I remove the control action, because control action I am applying from outside, so I can always able to do this kind of experiment that I can remove control action and after that I will see the behavior. Okay, and somehow people are telling that unforced behavior. Okay, so unforced behavior I can always able to measure. Now we are telling that suppose that I know the unforced behavior, that you can start anywhere inside the space and you are able to converge to the equilibrium point uniformly. Okay, so that kind of information I have. Now what I am going to do, I am going to apply some kind of bounded output and input, and after that I am going to see the behavior of the system. Okay, so what do you think, what kind of behavior comes into picture? So for that, let us start with the linear system. Okay, try to see the behavior. So because we already know that if linear system is stable, then bounded input will provide us, gives us bounded state, you can tell, or bounded output, you can tell. Okay, so here I am assuming that I cannot able to distinguish between output and state. That kind of assumption I have. So this is if this is a stable system. Okay, so now could you please tell me that if that is an unstable system and if I apply bounded input, then what is behavior? Sunidhi, could you please tell me, if I have an unstable system and if my control input is bounded, then what kind of behavior I have?
Unbounded output.
Unbounded. Okay. Yes. So here, what I have to first assume that without control, my system should be stable. And due to that reason, you can see that whenever I have started with linear time invariant system, here I am assuming that if I substitute u equal to 0, then I have system like this, x dot equal to ax. And could you please tell me that when this particular system is asymptotically or globally asymptotically about stable about the x equal to 0, what is condition? Nidhi ma'am, could you please tell me?
Eigenvalue should be negative. Or
so what is more technical word we are using for a system?
Herbert.
So same kind of things I have written here. Okay. After that, now you can see that I have just written the closed form solution, because whenever I have LTI system, I can write the solution, and solution is a t minus t0 x t0 and t0 to t e power a t minus tau t minus tau a and b u tau d tau. So that kind of way I can write the solution. Anyone has confusion on this solution, then please check the linear control. Several times I have written this solution. Okay, now here one more important thing. Here I am one thing I am telling you, that I am assuming that x belongs to Rn and u belongs to Rm. Okay, so that kind of assumption I have. After that, you see that since A is Hurwitz, so I can assume that I have n number of eigenvalue, even if that is complex eigenvalue, but their real part is negative. Okay, so I have n number of eigenvalues, and how one can decide the rate of convergence of this xt? Suppose for time being you can assume that there is no control action. Okay, so could you please tell me that how to decide, or how much time I have to wait with respect to eigenvalue such that system is going to settle to the equilibrium point? That is decided by the largest eigenvalue or slowest eigenvalue or smallest eigenvalue. Suppose all eigenvalue is negative, real part is negative. So what do you think? Final response is governed by what kind of eigenvalue? Means I have n number of eigenvalue, so some value might be in magnitude by that is larger, or someone is less larger, and after that negative sign is there. So obviously if that is more negative, I am telling, so I have more negative eigenvalue, less negative eigenvalue. So Ankit, could you please tell me that in absence of control, which
more negative converge?
Yeah, more negative will converge fastly, but I have to see the behavior of whole system. So behavior of whole system is governed by largest negative eigenvalue or smallest negative eigenvalue. What do you think?
Whole systems are then also large. means more negative.
Okay, try to see the situation. Suppose that means you are playing a game. Okay, so now you have to win. Okay, so it might possible some player are very much smart or some player are below average. What do you think? When you will win the game?
When the more smart people?
No, you have to see the less smart people also, because less smart people we have to make sure that, because most of time if we have finite number of smart people, in order to win game, team effort is important. Okay, so team effort is important. Then you have to see the those who are weaker. Okay, so actually what happens in terms of time also, you can see the same phenomena, that if lambda is a little lesser small, then what happens, their rate of convergence is very, very slow. So you have to wait for large time such that you are able to see the xt is going tending towards the zero. So that is governed by slowest eigenvalue. So any organization is always governed by slowest people. Okay, not by those people which has very, very good effort. Okay, so that kind of dynamics is always there. And people are telling that this kind of things. But here similar, mathematically you can able to see this. Okay, anyone has confusion? And due to that reason, I am selecting here lambda as a smallest eigenvalue. If you have any confusion, then please let me know. I want to calculate the bond. So some bond will decay quickly if lambda is very, very high. But behavior of this term is actually governed by the slowest one. Okay. So whenever you are going to bond, then you have to find all solution, and after that we have to see the smallest one. Okay. Now what I am going to do, I am going to take the norm, because I am not able to compare xt in higher dimensional space, and due to that reason, now I want to make some kind of inequality, and due to that reason I have taken norm on the both hand side, and you can see that now I have quantity a or x or y. So norm x and y, I can able to write that is less than equal to norm x plus norm y. Okay, so due to that reason I have written like this. Okay, now what I have done, I have substituted this kind of inequality, then we will get this kind of term. Anyone has confusion in this calculation? Now you can see here that here I have u tau is also involved. So I am assuming that there exists a supremum norm. Okay, supremum, how to calculate the infinity norm? Anyone, how to calculate the infinity norm? Suppose I have some kind of continuous vector that is evolving with respect to time, then I can, how many different way I can define the norm? Baby Dana, are you here? Okay. Edam, could you please tell me that how many different way I can define the norm?
Sir, infinite ways.
And I have selected the infinity norm. Okay, but you can select any other also. That is not a problem. Okay. So most of time, whenever, because all norm are equivalent in finite dimensional space, and due to that reason you can select any norm. So here, because this norm is always very comfortable to select, okay, so due to that reason I am assuming that there exists an infinite norm, and whenever you are going to calculate the infinity norm, then this will some number come into picture, and due to that reason you can interpret this whole quantity as a some number, and you are able to take it out. Anyone has confusion on this? And I am going to see the supremum over t0 to t. And why not maximum, why supremum? Could you please answer this? Because it might possible sometime ut involve in some kind of open set. Okay, open interval. At that time, it might possible there do not exist a maximum. Due to that reason, I am going to take the supremum. Anyone has confusion on this point, then please let me know. Now, if you don't have confusion, then this term is clear. Now I have a norm of B. Okay, so there are certain way to calculate the norm of matrices. Okay, please check it. So I have, I do not have calculated here. Just I have written like this. So one way, either you can take the sum of all column, absolute value of all column, and take the maximum one. Okay, either you can see the row, take the absolute value of row, and then pick the maximum sum. In that way, or another way, that what you can do, you can see the singular value and then you can define the square root of that. Okay, so in that way one can define the norm of matrices. Okay, now if this is number, now we have to solve this definite integral only, t0 to t e power k e power minus lambda, and after that I have k, sorry, I have written something wrong. So I have something like k e power minus lambda t minus tau and d tau. So I have to solve this. Okay. And I have to solve this for t0 to t. Okay. And it is possible to show, if you see the solution carefully, then I have k into e power minus lambda t minus t0. So at t equal to t0, I have some value. And after that, I have as t equal to t, at that time I have some value. Okay, so please calculate that value, and it is possible to show that I can able to get when this is t. So at that time lambda t minus some quantity is there. So at that time I have some number, and after that t minus t0. So t minus t0 is always decreasing, and due to that reason I need worst case situation, and due to that reason I have considered k by lambda only, and due to that reason k by lambda comes into picture. So please do that calculation by yourself. Anyone has confusion on that calculation, then I will do, or you can write like this, e power lambda t minus tau, and after that I have something like lambda. Now I have to calculate definite limit from t0 to t. Okay, so if you substitute tau here, you can see that I have k by lambda. If you substitute t0 here, and exponential term is here, so as t tending towards infinity, this term is going to decrease, and due to that reason I have considered the maximum one k by lambda. Okay, anyone has confusion on this equation 3? Now if you don't have confusion, let us try to see here that if I see xt carefully, then they have two term. Okay, one term is associated with the initial condition xt0, and another term that is associated with u tau. Okay, so basically I have non-autonomous system ax or linear time invariant system, and here two input is allowed, one input as a initial condition and another input as a control input. Okay, and after that we are getting the xt. Okay, now you can see that if I have no control action, and at that situation I have x dot equal to ax. So I have to make sure if there is no control, and if A is Hurwitz matrix I have already assumed, then xt tending towards 0. So is it possible to conclude from this solution or not? Ankit, what do you think? Is it possible to conclude from this solution that if u equal to 0, then xt tending towards 0 as t tending towards infinity? Is it possible to conclude? So that is obvious. Okay, now so that response is called zero input response. So if input is 0, at that time whatever response that comes into picture, that is called zero input response in case of linear system. Most of time you might have seen. So that is decaying exponentially with respect to time. Exponentially fast they are decaying. Now suppose that initial condition equal to 0. Okay, so now we are going to see the zero state response. So what do you think? What about the zero state response? Binay, could you please comment about the zero state response?
So in that case, only input will be there.
Yeah, input means this term is not there, this term at that time. Now I have input is here. So what one can comment? So is it possible to comment that if input is bonded, then XT is also bonded?
Vivo, I think, sir.
Yeah, Vivo stability. Yeah. Okay, because I am assuming output as a all state variable. Okay, and due to that reason, we have written the second observation. While the zero state response is bounded for every bounded input. Okay, so what is the story? That if I will apply bounded input here, then I can tell that all state, okay, that remains the bounded. So same kind of things actually I have written from the solution, two things. So I have zero input response. Zero input response means you can just make sure that input equal to zero. And what is response? So response due to just initial condition. So that is called zero input response. What is meaning of zero state response? Now what you can do, you can keep a state equal to zero. And a state is nothing but, you know that any initial condition I can interpret as a state, because that will carry all information from past to that particular time. So zero state response, whenever we are going to calculate, at that time we have to just make sure that initial condition equal to zero. Okay, so in case of zero state response, what we have observed, that if input is bounded, then our state is also bounded. Okay, so overall, if you see the whole solution now, okay, so what one can comment about the full solution? Ankit, could you please comment something about the, now suppose that I am assuming that I have both input as well as the state, then what one can comment? Could you please comment about this solution? This solution, Ankit?
Generally, we call it a complete solution, sir.
Okay, complete
means
solution.
Which include the CF and PI, means complement effect and particular integral.
No, don't go
this
to
is
that.
This kind of solution.
Don't go to that, because now we are not going to talk about the exact solution. We are just going to talk about estimation of the solution. So this is not the exact solution. Okay, this one is the exact solution. At that time, whatever you have told, that is correct. Okay, but if you see the three, that is not an exact solution. Okay, so I cannot comment whatever you have told. Okay, try to see the distance difference between first solution and this solution. Okay, this is complete solution, but this is estimation of the solution. Okay, and I am asking what one can comment about the estimation of the solution. Okay, so now could you please comment? So from this expression, is it possible to tell that even if I have non-zero initial state, then again response remains bounded? Is it possible to comment? Ankit, is it?
Yes, sir, we can. Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Because
we
this can. Term is decreasing with respect to time.
Yes.
So from this, yes, I can comment that much. Okay. So same kind of things I have written here, that in fact, the estimate shows more than a bounded input, bounded state property. They are telling that what response is also telling. They are telling that the bound of zero state response is proportional to the bound of the input. Okay. So they are not only telling that bounded input, bounded output, but they are telling that how basically bound of solution is vary. So that kind of information also one can get from the estimation of the solution. Okay. Now I have already told you that my concern is the nonlinear system. Okay. So what I am going to do, I am going to now take the general nonlinear force system. Okay, so non-autonomous force linear nonlinear system I have. Now what we are telling, for a general nonlinear system, it should not be surprising that this property may not hold. Okay, even if origin of unforced system is globally uniformly asymptotically stable. What we are telling, that I am going to keep control equal to zero, and when control equal to zero, then x equal to zero is globally uniformly asymptotically stable. Okay, now what I am going to do, I am going to apply the bounded control. Okay, so now what we are going to do, we are going to construct one example. Okay, Here you can see that in this particular example, I haven't involved the time term, but you can involve here in place of one, you can write the time. So first you can consider this system fxu. Okay, so this system is nonlinear autonomous system, and they have also some kind of forcing function. So force nonlinear autonomous system, nonlinear because 2x square is here. Now you can see that if you keep u equal to 0 at that time, what kind of system I have? I have system like x dot equal to minus 3x. Okay, so and here I am assuming that I have just first order system. So could you please comment that if I have x dot equal to minus 3x, then what kind of stability I can talk about the equilibrium point x equal to 0? Sunidhi, could you please comment?
So we can talk about globally also exponentially stable.
Yeah, globally exponentially stable, because here you can see that whatever this is single input system, means this is just one dimensional system. So eigenvalue is minus 3. Okay, and eigenvalue is minus 3 means I have a linear system. So that is always linear system with negative eigenvalue is exponentially stable, and due to that reason I have exponential stability, and this is valid for everywhere in a space because system is linear, and due to that reason that is globally exponentially stable for u equal to 0. Now what you can do, you can apply the bounded input, and I have applied for u equal to 1, and after that I have solved it. So after solving, I get this kind of solution. Okay, now could you please tell me that this solution remains bounded or not? Anyone? Iram, could you please comment about this solution by showing, seeing this solution? What I have done, I have substituted u equal to 1, and whatever differential equation I have, so either you can solve using Mathematica, or you can solve using any standard tool, or you can solve, even if you can solve by hand, because that is possible, one dimensional equation only. So by variable separation you can solve, and solution is written like this. So what one can comment about the solution? Iram, could you please comment?
Sir, it is not a bounded solution.
Obviously, you see that as 3, because second term 2e by e power t, that is varying with respect to time. So there exists certain moment when I have this kind of situation 2 et. Okay. So if I will calculate the time, so time is nothing but ln 3 by 2. So at this finite time, denominator of this xt is tending towards 0, or become exactly at a 0, at that time xt tending towards the infinity. So you can see that in case of nonlinear system, even if equilibrium point is globally exponentially stable, and if I apply a bounded control, if I have applied a bounded control, then a still solution is become unbounded. Okay, it is possible to show if you just replace 1 by t, then similar kind of conclusion comes into picture. Okay, so please do that by yourself. Okay, and due to that reason, what I have written, let us view the system x dot equal to ftxu as a perturbation of unforced system x dot equal to ftx0. So what we are assuming now, you am considering some kind of perturbation. When I have started the lecture, I have told you that why this kind of concept is very much important for me. So even if I can design some kind of nice control system, and system is showing that that our closed loop system is working fine, still that will not work when that will come in the realistic environment, because realistic environment always has certain kind of perturbation. Okay, so due to that reason, either you can interpret control as a perturbation, okay, or you can do like this, you can divide control in two part. One part is going to make sure that closed loop system, that is exponentially, globally exponentially stable, and after that you try to see the behavior about the another control part u0 and plus ud, you can see. So suppose with respect to u0, I have substituted u0 in terms of t and x, and that system is has certain kind of unforced system, has certain kind of behavior, or forced system, partially forced system has certain kind of behavior. Now we are going to see the behavior about the perturbation. Means if some bounded control now comes into picture, then what one can do, what one can see. So due to that reason, this problem, one can see that they can interpret this problem like this, that I have one force system which has certain behavior. Now you, I can consider as a some kind of disturbance and bounded disturbance. So same kind of things I am going to interpret here now. Suppose we have Lyapunov function for this system and force system for this system, and let us calculate the derivative of V in presence of U. Okay, so in previous class we have learned about boundedness and ultimate boundedness. Okay, so could you please summarize, Iram, could you please summarize the boundedness and ultimate boundedness, what we have learned in the previous class?
Sir, boundedness, it comes into picture when we don't know the equilibrium point of the system.
Yeah, exactly.
So in that case, we can say that even if the solution doesn't reach the equilibrium point, but it is bounded. And if after a finite time, it reaches the some constant, then it means
that I have two different kind of response. One response is called transient response, another is called a steady state response. Okay, so after some finite time, it will reach to the some steady state response. At that time, whatever bond that become less conservative, and I can tell that trajectory or XT remains ultimate bond, means ultimately bonded. And due to that reason, we are defining the ultimate bondedness. Okay. So similar kind of concept now I am telling, unforced system, I know the about the unforced system, and now U is some kind of, I am interpreting some kind of disturbance. So in presence of disturbance, what happens? It might possible equilibrium will not preserve. So I can now interpret this problem in terms of the boundedness or some kind of boundedness of solution in presence of some kind of disturbance such that equilibrium is not remains the consistent. Okay, and due to that reason, I have written that due to the boundedness of U, it is possible that in some case it should be possible to show that V dot is negative outside the ball. Okay, what happens that whenever I don't know the equilibrium point, or equilibrium point, there exists a equilibrium point, but that is varying with respect to some parameter. In previous class I have given very simple example for that. So delta sin t is here. So you can see that whenever we are going to calculate the equilibrium point, at that time I am going to substitute x dot equal to 0. So basically at that time my equilibrium point x star is delta sin t, and sin t is varying from minus 1 to 1, and due to that reason equilibrium point is also varying from minus delta to plus delta. So I don't know the equilibrium point, but there exists a equilibrium point. So at that time what happens, that due to this term and this term, you can see that is bounded. If delta is bounded, then what happens? If we see the Lyapunov theory, at that time I can define Lyapunov function like this, half x square, and if I see the derivative of Lyapunov function, at that time I have situation like x square plus x delta sin t. This kind of situation I have, and it is possible to show that this term is strictly negative, because x square, or you can replace it by 2v from this relationship, and after that x delta sin t. So this term is not sin definite, but this is always sin definite. I know that here 2v is always negative, and due to that reason, what happens, v dot, initially v dot is going to decrease, and that is after some time what happens, v dot stop decreasing. And due to that reason, we are telling that at least in this region, I can tell that here V dot greater than 0 and V dot less than 0. If I have just some kind of bounded kind of situation, otherwise if that is valid everywhere, then I can tell that outside of this, I have V dot less than 0 and here V dot greater than 0. So trajectory decrease up to here, and once that will trap here, they will not leave. Okay, so same kind of things I have seen here. So you can see here that if I interpret this disturbance, this control as some kind of disturbance, okay, so similar kind of interpretation I can tell that if disturbance remains bounded, then and if I develop some kind of Lyapunov function for this system when there is no disturbance, so disturbance free Lyapunov function, so that will not throughout decrease to the zero. In presence of disturbance, what happens after some time, that Lyapunov function stop decreasing. And if I know the ball of the disturbance, okay, or some maximum value of disturbance, then I can tell something, I can comment something. In previous class, we have seen, we have related that ultimate bound with respect to the Lyapunov function. Okay, so similar kind of things now, we are going to take help of same analysis in order to define the input to state stability formulation for the nonlinear system. So what we are telling now, in presence of the control, I have to make sure this. Why this is required? Because if I don't know this, then I cannot tell that there exists a solution. Okay, now what happens that since Lyapunov function is decreasing, so Lyapunov function is decreasing, it means that there exists some kind of KL class function. Okay, so if my initial condition is larger, then I have to wait for large time. And if I have lesser initial condition, then quickly I will converge. Okay, and since V dot less than 0, so I am converging towards equilibrium point. Due to that reason, there exists a class KL function. Okay, we have already seen this kind of things, that if I have some kind of system which is converging towards the equilibrium point, then solution I can write in form of the class KL function. And due to that reason, I am telling that up to T0 to T0 plus T, in some finite time T, what happens that solution can be governed by this equation, and beta is nothing but some kind of KL class function. Okay, now what happens based on the ball of this U? Okay, U I am going to interpret as a disturbance. What happens now after some time they stop decreasing? Okay, and in previous class, what we have seen that if Vx is going to lie between two K class function alpha 1 and alpha 2x, at that time I can tell that what is size of the ultimate bond. And what we found at that time, size is alpha 1 inverse alpha 2, and in place of x you can substitute the ball of that disturbance mu, so like this. And due to that reason, what happens that up to t, this finite time t0 to t, solution is going to decrease, and after that they stop decreasing, but they do not leave the region because that region is invariant or some kind of closed and bounded region, that compact region. Okay, so V dot greater than 0, so solution cannot leave that region, and that region I can define using class K function. Okay, so what I am suggesting, those who has not attended the previous class, please attend it, then you are able to understand how basically this particular bond come into picture. But up to here, I hope that you are able to understand, at least from the intuition, that since I have constructed some kind of Lyapunov function and U is bounded disturbance, so a still Lyapunov function, whatever I have constructed for the unforced system, that behaved nicely up to some point, and after that they stop decreasing. Why? Because U is there, and I am interpreting as a perturbation. So basically I have two phase. In one phase, trajectory start decreasing, and after some time they stop it. Okay, so this is called transient behavior. And in a steady state behavior, what happens, once trajectory will come here, then they settle down. Okay, and due to that reason, I have some kind of behavior that is governed by K class function. Okay, and K class function, since alpha 1 is class K, alpha 2 is class K, so their composition, alpha inverse is also class K, since alpha 1 is class K, and their composition become class K. So if U is bounded by large amount, then you can see that this ball size is bigger. So same kind of information here I am transmitting. So I have two different response, same like linear system. I have transient response and I have a steady state response. And if you add both, then I can able to find the whole solution like this. Anyone has confusion? So if solution here, norm is missing. So if solution is bounded like this, then we are telling that I can able to give definition for the bounded definition for the input to state stability for the nonlinear system if this kind of phenomena happens. Okay, anyone has confusion on this up to here? And due to that reason, you can see now that you are able to picture out why people has defined input to state stability of the non-autonomous force system in this way. What people are telling that if I have some kind of non-autonomous force system, that force system is input to state stable, and what you can do, they are telling that you can substitute u equal to 0, and u equal to 0, you can find some kind of Lyapunov function, and you are lucky that that unforced system is stable, then I have some kind of in some part of the space Lyapunov function start decreasing along the trajectory. Okay, and since u is going to play like disturbance, so they stop decreasing after some time, but once they trap inside some region, then they cannot leave, because outside region, whatever region we are constructed, that is closed and bounded and invariant too. Okay, because v dot less than 0 outside of that, and due to that region, now I have this kind of definition, same kind of things. Now I am going to state using definition. I am telling that the system that is non-autonomous force system is said to be input to a state stable if there exists a class KL function, because trajectory is going to decrease with respect to x t0 and t minus t0, and due to that reason class KL function comes into picture. And there exists a class K function gamma such that any initial time x t0 and any bounded input ut solution will satisfy this kind of condition. And whenever ut I have, we are defining with respect to supremum. So what we have done here, you can see that here alpha 1 inverse and alpha 2 and mu in place of mu, I have substituted the supremum value of the control for t0 to t, whatever time of our observation or time of our experiment. So I have started experiment as t0 and I have actually given control up to t. So at that time I will take the supremum value and this kind of estimate of solution hold. And if that kind of things holds, then we will tell that system is input to state stable. So anyone has confusion that why this definition comes into picture, then please let me know. Because if you are able to understand this, then half part of a story is solved. Anyone? Then please let me know. Now what I am telling that, suppose if you are able to understand that why this solution will comes into picture, then inequality 5 guaranteed that any bounded input, the state remains the bounded. So this nonlinear system has similar kind of property like the linear system, provided you can assume that all output as a state. And later phase, people are also defined the input to output stability for nonlinear system if I have limited information of the or limited state that is reflected on the output. Okay, and you can see that further, as t increases, the xt will be ultimately bounded with some kind of k class function that is given by this, because this is decreasing. So ultimate bound or bound in the transient is means when transient is over, that is given like this, so that is obvious. Okay, one can also able to prove this, so proof is not so difficult. So how one can prove? So after proof, I will close this lecture. You can see that if I use inequality 5 and ut, suppose that ut converges towards the 0 as t converges towards the infinity, so we have to show that xt also converges towards the 0. Okay, so it is very easy to show. What we will do, in order to show the convergence, what I have to show that this xt less than epsilon for all t that is tending towards the infinity, if we are able to show this, then I can tell that xt tending towards 0, because I can able to make epsilon as small as possible. Okay, so as t equal to infinity, I am able to make sure that xt tending towards the 0. Okay, so let us try to see the proof. What I will do, first I will select epsilon, and out of that epsilon, what I am going to do, I am going to find t take some kind of epsilon 1. And epsilon 1, how basically I have defined epsilon 1, I have substituted this epsilon 1 at the gamma function. And after that, I'm assuming that after some time, since control is decreasing, here you can see that here I'm assuming that ut is converging towards the zero. So finally, this gamma function, that is k class function, that is going to decrease. That is not gamma function, this is gamma as a function. There are difference between gamma function and gamma as a function. Okay, and due to that reason, I have repeated this statement. So gamma is actually k class function. So I have some variable that I have defined as a k class function. And since argument of that is decreasing, so due to that reason, I can assume that that is at some moment, this inequality holds. Okay, after that, now you can see that it means that as t tending towards t1, I can able to tell that ut, when ut is less than equal to epsilon, this part, whole part is less than equal to epsilon by 2. Okay, now this is also decreasing with respect to time. So I can assume that there exists some kind of time t1. At that time, this function, since this is decreasing with respect to time, so this function particularly, that is less than epsilon by 2. Okay, and since this is epsilon by 2, so finally I can able to solve to see that xt is less than equal to t, and maximum of t1 and t2, I don't know t1 and t2, due to that reason I have to tell that whatever is this finite time t exists, that is maximum of t1 and t2, because t0 greater than equal to t1, then this inequality will satisfy that this part is less than epsilon by 2, and I have one more time. We have stated here t greater than equal to t1, at that time basically ut or this relation will satisfy. Due to that reason, I have to take the maximum of the both time t1 and t2, then I can tell that that is converging towards the zero. And you can see obvious, this case is obvious, that if ut is zero, then I have some kind of k class function, and unforced system is globally uniformly asymptotically stable. Okay, up to here, anyone has confusion? If you don't have confusion, then what I am going to do, I am just going to take one example, and after that I am going to close the today's lecture. So you can see here, I have taken some system x dot equal to minus x cube e power minus t, and after that what I have done, I have defined the Lyapunov function. And what is guidelines to define Lyapunov function? Just you can extract those part or some kind of part where disturbance is, you can interpret that as a input or disturbance. So I have interpreted e power minus t as a some kind of disturbance which is decreasing with respect to time. You can see that e power minus t is there. Now I have defined Lyapunov function 1 power 4 x power 4 for this particular x dot equal to minus x cube. And after that, what we found that v dot, I can write this. And after that, I have write what we have done. We have seen that in which region actually Lyapunov function is going to decrease and when they are going to stop the decrease. So in order to find that, we know that this term is actually sign indefinite because x cube is there. So what I have done, I have taken the worst case analysis. And in this worst case analysis, you can see that if I am able to maintain x like this, so I can able to show that how basically people are doing, they are trying to separate this term in two part, and after that they are telling that, or x6 into two part, and after that they are telling that some part is going to dominate. So here I have x6 and theta x6 is there. So now whatever remaining part, and what kind of remaining part I have, I can tell that I have some kind of remaining part, that is theta, and that is because I have to make sure that summation of these two become this. So I will separate this quantity into theta x power 6, and I am telling that this part is going to take care about this part, e power minus t0, this part. Okay, and if that is taken care about this part, then trajectory is going to decrease, and after that they stop decreasing. Okay, and in this way I can able to find the bound of the solution, and I can tell that if I have this kind of situation, so t tending towards 0 means disturb, here I have this kind of situation that I can give guarantee that xt is greater than equal to 2 remains this, and that is mu I have. After that, now what we have to do? I can able to find the bond. Okay, so how to find the bond? You can see here that xt is less than equal to epsilon for all t. So I can adjust this time. Okay, how basically one can adjust this time? E power minus t0, you can see that that remains the constant. But theta, okay, theta I can tell that that is adjustable. And if I will wait for this time t greater than equal to t, then what happens? That this trajectory is going to converge to the zero. And it is possible to see from here also, because this is decreasing due to that region. I can expect that as t tending towards infinity, then this is going to decrease. Okay, and in this way I can able to find the finite time where that is going to enter inside this particular set. Okay, so now it is time to conclude the today's lecture. So what we have found in today's lecture, that whenever I have some kind of force non-autonomous system, okay, so is it possible to extend same kind of concept like Bebo stability, bonded input bonded output stability, provided I am assuming that output is nothing but all the state variable. Okay, so what we found, that for general class system I cannot do, but if I will solve the equation, differential equation, and if solution will satisfy that first function is KL class function with respect to initial condition and t minus t0, and second one with respect to the control, that is some kind of K class function, then I can tell that system behave like bounded input, bounded output, or bounded input, or state to input to state stable. Input is bounded, then state remains the bounded. So that is called ISS property. So by seeing the solution, I can tell that system has similar behavior like the linear system. Again, you can see that first I am solving the equation, and after that I am establishing. So what do you think? What is second option? Anyone? Kalol, could you please think about second option? One option is that I have some way to solve the equation, and I have established definition of ISS by looking towards the solution. What do you think? What is another obvious way? I think that mic of Kalol is not working. So now Sunidhi, could you please answer this question?
Sir, opposite of that we first
Ankit, could you please guess? So do not worry, even guess is bad, that is also not a matter for me.
No idea, sir.
Okay. Iram?
Sir, by using some boundedness.
So, okay, let us again come to the Lyapunov theory. When I have started Lyapunov theory, you might have seen that first I am establishing in terms of epsilon and delta. At that time, I am seeing the solution. After that, what I have done? I have constructed energy-like function. Okay, and I am just checking that energy-like function, whatever solution of energy-like function, that will satisfy that kind of condition. Okay, so similar kind of things here I will do. I will construct Lyapunov function, and I am trying to show using the help of Lyapunov function that whatever the estimation of solution, that will satisfy KL class function. There exists a KL class function and K class function. Okay, and that is the story of the next class. In next class, I am not going to solve the differential equation. What I am going to do, I am going to establish everything in terms of the Lyapunov function. Okay, and we are going to give some kind of method such that Lyapunov theory can be extended for ISS, input to state stability. Okay, so a story remains exactly the same. In order to guess the definition, I have used the concept of solution or concept of boundedness of the solution or uniform ultimately boundedness. And after that, what I am going to look in the next class, that if solution is not available, okay, or estimation of solution is not available, then how to define Lyapunov function, and again using Lyapunov function, how to talk about input to state stability. Okay, So with this remark, I am going to end the today's lecture. So if you have any confusion, then please let me know. Okay, if you don't have confusion, then I am going to end the today's lecture. Thank you very much.